Welcome to the Health Fix Podcast, where health junkies get their weekly fix of tips, tools, and techniques to have limitless energy, sharp minds, and fit physiques for life.
Hey, health junkies. On this episode of the Health Fix Podcast, I'm interviewing Jannine Grover from the Gutsy Health Podcast that's ranked in the top 50 podcasts. She's a big deal. Now, I was on her podcast way back in 2021, episode 79. So if you're wanting to hear me from back in the day, check it out. It's a fun podcast. Now, Jannine is dedicated to health advocacy and really helping folks to advocate for themselves, because that's part of her story. And you'll hear all about it in this podcast. Now, from her Gutsy Academy to many foundational health courses, and also being the founder and owner of the Provo Health Clinic in Utah, she's helping a lot of folks. Now, Jannine overcame Graves' disease naturally. She triumphed over mold toxicity, chronic inflammatory response syndrome, long COVID, and a spectrum of autoimmune issues. She's impressive, let me tell you. Now, she embodies resilience and innovation in the holistic health world. And today we're going to be talking all about hormones in the gut, as well as what Jannine's found to be the order of healing to restore your health. So we have a lot in common, and really when it comes to health and helping clients and what it takes to restore your health. So this one's a good one. Anyone that has hormones, that's all of you. And for anyone struggling with chronic health conditions and just sick of moving two steps forward and four steps back, this is the podcast you want to listen to. So let's introduce you to Jannine Grover. Jannine Grover, welcome to the Health Fix Podcast.
Thank you so much for having me. I've been so looking forward to this.
Oh my gosh, we finally did it.
It was a whole story. Like, we tried to record this like a month ago and my baby was losing his mind, and you were so kind. You're like, you know what? Let's just redo it. And so thank you. I really appreciate it.
No problem. The energy was not aligned that day, since my computer also was feeling your baby and was like, yeah, no, let's just cancel. Let's call it a day. So here we are, folks. And guess what? After a month, we've worked up some good stuff for you. Today, we're going to be talking about the gut, of course, because Jannine is all about the gut, being the Gutsy Mom, and her podcast, of course, we'll get to that too. But the gut, autoimmune stuff, this is how you met your gut, right? Is this how you guys kind of became acquainted and really dove into it? Tell me the background story, because it's been a while since I've been refreshed.
It's a long story. I'll try and shorten it. So when I had my son, I got Graves' disease. And for people that understand, like, at the core of all autoimmune dysfunction is gut dysfunction. And so, and like stress and, you know, like sympathetic dominance. But I had to become kind of like a gut expert and a food expert, because, you know, my doctors were like, no, you have to go on medication for the rest of your life. And I was like, absolutely not. Give me 6 months and I'm going to reverse this. And they laughed at me and they're like, that's impossible. You can't reverse Graves' disease. And I was like, watch me. There's people that have done it before. So, you know, you have to learn about food and the gut and all that stuff. And so I started there. But where I actually became a great gut expert was my late husband was diagnosed with colon cancer. And so you have to become a gut expert, right? And so, you know, it's like, well, why did this happen? And how do we help him? And how do we support him? And so I became an expert, but like, I did a ton of research around colon cancer and the gut biome and, you know, just gut in general. And so I learned about, you know, gut dysfunction and dysbiosis. But during my husband's cancer journey, I started getting a ton of gut dysfunction myself, because I was so stressed out. I couldn't understand why I was burping all the time and why I had heartburn all the time. And, you know, why I had to take like 8 digestive enzymes per meal, because like, I just wasn't digesting my food. And so I had to like figure it out, right? Like, I was reading, it's different when you read about gut dysfunction and when you suffer with gut dysfunction, you know? And so, my whole life I struggled with constipation. My daughter was like, as soon as she started solids, she started with constipation. Mm-hmm. And I was realizing that's a connective tissue issue as well as a microbial issue. And And so, so I became a gut expert that way. And then I just started teaching classes because again, like there's so many dysfunctions that start in the gut, right? Like you have to, if you want to become a health expert, you actually have to be a gut expert. And so I created an entire course teaching people how to become gut healing experts because it's not hard. It's just, there's many parts to it, right? And I think that people deserve to understand the parts so that they can fix it. It's kind of like buying a car, but like never reading the manual on how to drive it and how to like fix it, right? And so I'm like, your gut is like this incredible car that can work for you, but can also break down if you don't know how to take care of it or fix it or, you know, all those things. And so, and then like after my husband died, I got hit with all other kinds of autoimmune issues like MCAS and long COVID and like mold toxicity and like the whole thing. So I became an expert, not just by reading books and studying it in school, but because I became my own patient, right? Like I have this clinic that deals with people that have Lyme disease. And I'm like, and I just started experiencing symptoms like Lyme disease and MCAS. And so I've had to not only be the expert, but experience the symptoms of it to help reverse it. And so here we are. That's my story.
Oh my goodness. Well, you know, I think we learn from experience, right? And 100%. The best folks out there are the ones who have gone through it, right? Mm-hmm. And that's yes. how I feel about hormones. I have been dealing with hormones, you know, madness mm-hmm. for quite some time. And that's kind of why I started to specialize in it, because that was where, you know, you start to realize, oh my gosh, I've done the homework, I've been through it, and I've got myself on the other side. Which yep. power to you for telling the docs, like, yo, watch me. I've got this, because that's one of the things that, you know, I love about you and your podcast and your clinic, because I have patients that go to Jannine's clinic. So this is a fun thing. And we'll talk about that connection here in a minute. But being your own self-healing advocate is like where I want everyone to really be thinking, right? We yeah. have to think about this, because
right.
the medical system, not going to help you. Clinics right. like Provo Health going to get you there, but you still have to do your own work. So let's talk a little bit about self-advocacy, but also like putting in the work and some of the steps you were talking about for gut health, because we had talked earlier and Jannine said the most beautiful thing. Hormones are sprinkling on your cake. Mm-hmm. I love that. So I'm going to stop talking. Let's tell folks kind of the steps it takes to really work on the gut and where we need to be thinking about. Cause I think a lot of people are like, oh, I just take this pill or I just take my enzymes and I'm good. No, right. Let's do hormones.
Right. Well, before we talk about the order of healing and hormones, yeah. like I want to touch on what you were saying about self-advocacy, yes. right? Because, you know, I'm actually a college dropout and I started a clinic that's one of the biggest clinics in Utah. And I have like 25 employees that I've trained. And, you know, I now work with Dr. Wright, who is the doctor at Provo Health. But before him, like, he's just been there since December. You know, Provo Health has been this full-fledged clinic with no doctors at all, helping thousands of people. I have 5 coaches that have schedules that are full all the time because they're helping people become self-healing advocates, right? And so what I want people to understand is that it is your responsibility to heal. It's not your doctor's, right? And you don't have to be a doctor to understand, to have the keys to the kingdom to heal, right? Like it's not rocket science. You don't have to go to medical school for this. Like everyone is entitled to understand their bodies and to fix the problems, because, you know, 95% of the healing is what you do at home, and it's what you learn, and it's what you practice on a day-to-day basis. Like the 5% is just dialing in your healing plan with your doctor or with your health coach or expert or something, you know? And so I really want that ingrained in people's minds as they go throughout their healing process, because I want them to have that paradigm shift of like, this is my responsibility. I am my responsibility. I need to read the manual to my machine, right? The machine being this body. Like, and so with that, the reason why I started the podcast and the reason why, you know, I started all the courses online, you know, is I understand the clinic is important, but it's for those that are like really, really sick and just are not finding answers. And so we get all the, I want to say this as lovingly as possible. And I got this phrase from Dr. Wright. He says, we get all the medical rejects, right? They just go from doctor to doctor to doctor. And like the doctors aren't finding answers. And then they eventually come to us and then we find answers and help them. Right. But we want to help the other, like the 99.9% of people that aren't the medical, that are still struggling and not getting answers, but they're not in bed and they're not like, you know, crippled yet. Like you have a responsibility to get all the information from like Dr. Jannine's podcast and my podcast and classes and whatever, and then implement the tools, right? And so part of my platform is teaching people how to be the advocates and then only utilizing tools if they really need to, like clinics and whatnot. So everything that you can do can be done at home. With that being said, the order of healing, right? Like what, before we started podcasting, I was talking about like how hormones, so many people have hormone issues, right? And hormones are so, they're big motivators, because if you have hormone imbalances, you know, you have weight issues, you have skin issues, you have hair issues, you have nail issues. It's like all the things that make you look and feel beautiful, right? Like energy and whatever, libido, like that's what it affects a lot. And so people want to fix hormones, but they don't realize it's the sprinkling on the cake. It's not the cake, right? Like hormones, there's an order to healing, and hormones are second to last, right? Like hormones are just like, they are the thing that becomes imbalanced when your body is starting to go through a crisis, but people don't realize the crisis has been building up for years, if not decades, you know? And so when it comes to the order of healing, I want people to recognize that there are things upstream that you need to heal before you go on like healing protocols for hormones and hormone protocols specifically. And so is now a good time to go into the order of healing and what people should consider?
Let's do it. Yes. Yes, of course. Perfect.
So I created the order of healing I can't remember. It was like 3 or 4 years ago when I was starting to podcast a lot and learn a lot. And I'm like, man, people really need to understand that if they try to skip steps, they're not going to succeed. And so I was seeing a lot of people trying to skip steps. And I'm like, no, we have to go back to square one. So number one is mindset. And mindset is really important, because like if you are, you know, this could mean a lot of things, like, you know, if you're in sympathetic dominance or if you're in a parasympathetic state, people don't realize that your brain is kind of like the control center, right? And so if your brain is like, think of it like the thermostat in the house, right? Let's say it's summertime and your thermostat is set at 80, right? And you're like, man, it's hot in this house. Let's just get a bunch of buckets of ice and try to cool down the house. Like that makes no sense, right? You're buying a lot of ice. There's ice buckets all over the house. And people are like, oh, well, we're a little bit cooler, but not really cool, because this house is still really warm. Exactly. Because the thermostat's at 80. Like you have to fix the thermostat. You don't need to buy buckets of ice. Just fix the freaking thermostat, right? And so the brain is like the thermostat. If you are in sympathetic dominance, there's going to be a whole cascade of inflammatory chemical reactions happening in your body, because your brain is telling your body to be in an inflamed state, to be in a fight or flight state, to be in a state to run from a bear, or to not sleep, or to, you know, be in fight or flight all the time. And so it's this heightened cortisol state where you're ready to get up and run at any moment, right? Like that's not a state that is conducive to healing and repairing. And so when people are in a healing crisis, you know, they try to outsource healing by taking supplements and by doing like controlling their diets and all the things. And I'm like, those things are helpful, but that's like buying the buckets of ice, right? Versus fixing the thermostat. So one is mindset. Mindset is getting out of sympathetic dominance and into a parasympathetic state, which is healing and repairing. It's rest and digest and heal, right? And so you have to now start training your brain to implement healing chemical reactions throughout your body, right? You need to train your brain to like calm your body down and your nervous system down and to allow it to rest. You know, 80% of healing and repairing happens when we're sleeping. So many people that have these healing like hormone issues or healing crisis, like they're not sleeping well. You know, when I ask, what's your sleep like? They're like, oh, I have a hard time falling asleep. I'm like, that's your problem. Right? Like you can try and outsource your healing with supplements and food, but if your brain isn't telling your body to heal, you will not heal, right? It's like trying to swim upstream. Like healing should be like floating downstream. It should be easy and in flow, and it shouldn't be hard. Right. And so when people are like going three steps forward, three steps back, three steps forward, three steps back, this is often why they're working against their own body's chemistry, right? The body is literally like, let's be in fight or flight all the time. And you're like, oh, let's try and take these supplements to heal and repair our body. And the body's like, nah, like I'm being told by the control center to be in fight or flight all the time. We're not healing right now. We're supposed to be running from a bear. I don't have time to heal. I have time to run from a bear, but I don't have time to heal, right? And so you will constantly have the three steps forward, three steps back, three steps forward. Like your own body will sabotage your own healing things that you try to implement. So mindset's number one.
So huge. So huge. Right. This three steps forward, you know, eight steps back, you know, whatever it may be. I see it all the time. And I have a lot of folks will be like, yeah, something works for me for like a month and then it doesn't work. And I'm like, nervous system.
Yes. Like, and that's so hard to teach patients, right? Because they actually don't understand how important it is, right? It's just like, you can tell them, but they can't conceptualize it because their baseline, and I think like this is 95 to 98% of Americans, where our baseline is a stress response, right? We are constantly checking out or we are constantly in a heightened state. And we think this is normal because this has been trained into our children, right? We train them to be extremely athletic and extremely studious, and they have to get A's, and they weren't taught to like run and play and regulate, right? And so I think the world of parenting is changing, where we're trying to do gentle parenting. Like if your children have these outbursts, you can like co-regulate instead of be like, go to your room and think about what you did. It's more like a, hey, you're experiencing something hard. Like here, borrow my nervous system. Let's help you calm down. And then let's talk about it when you're not in your amygdala. Let's talk about it when your prefrontal cortex is back online. You know what I mean? And so, you know, trying to train, and what I mean by that, and I'll quickly explain. When we are in an amygdala response, that's our fight or flight response, right? And so children have very undeveloped brains, and it's our job as parents to help mirror to them prefrontal cortex responses. But their amygdalas are so overactive, you know, that they're going to have freakouts all the time, and they're going to fight all the time, and they're going to be dysregulated all the time. That's not their fault. That's just developmentally where they are at right now, right? And so I think old parenting styles was they're in their amygdala and they get an amygdala response from the parent of like, you're bad, right? And they're just like, I'm terrible. And so then their amygdala is now more active. Whereas, you know, again, this starts from young. And I have a whole course around this in my Gutsy Academy, where it's called the Mind, Body, Soul course, where we teach people like, hey, like there's a subconscious like programming here where you're in this fight or flight response all the time because it was so ingrained in you from a young age. Now we get to untrain that, right? So anyways, amygdala, prefrontal cortex, it's a whole thing. That's mindset. It's a whole thing, right? Like, but we can't do that in our consults. When you're talking with patients, like it's so hard to like spend hours talking to them about their brain function and how it's so intertwined with their healing, right?
It is. I mean, unfortunately, you know, I feel like that's where the medical system fails, right? Because I still am in the system, you know, I still take insurance. And so I feel that's where it fails because I'm so much like, guys, if we could have like 3 hours together, let's just go for a 3-hour hike. I could solve a lot of your problems, but I don't have that time. Yeah. So this is where courses come in, so that we got videos and we've got group stuff. So, you know, we need the support there. We need the support there. So I think a lot of people are like, okay, so my gut is jacked because my mindset and my nervous system.
Yes. So we're going to get to step two and three. So step two is actually mitochondria. Everyone's like, what does this have to do with hormones? I promise we're getting there. Like we I will. promise. So step two is actually mitochondria, and a quick like anatomy lesson. Mitochondria are the powerhouses of the cells, right? And they are they're kind of like the batteries that create the energy for your whole body to function. So it's, think of it like electricity. If you don't have electricity to a house, you don't have any lights on. So if we don't have mitochondria producing ATP, which is the energy for the cells, like your cells don't work, right? And so if you're in a healing crisis, you need a ton of ATP for your body to heal and repair itself, right? So think of it like you're in a health crisis because you went into biological debt, right? Like you spent a lot of money on credit cards and now you have to pay that back with a ton of interest. You're going to need a lot of biological currency to pay all that back, right? Think of the ATP like the currency. The ATP is the energy that pays it all back, that helps the cells function to turn over and heal and repair themselves, or to allow apoptosis to happen so they die, but we create newer, healthier cells, right? All of that requires energy, all of it. And so if you don't have functioning mitochondria, you don't have the ATP to pay back all of that debt and interest, right? The biological debt and interest. So you have to have really healthy mitochondria to do that. And unfortunately, mitochondria, they're kind of like fairies. They're really sensitive, right? Mm-hmm. And so they can be oxidized very easily. They can be damaged really easily. They age. So as we age, they age. And so depending on how much stress you are exposed to, you are aging your mitochondria faster. But the beauty about mitochondria is that you can anti-age them. So there's things you can do to heal and repair them and anti-age them to a certain state or to a certain extent. Right. So you can't like, you can't be 50 and be like, I want 10-year-old mitochondria. It's not going to happen. Right. And so, but if you're 50 and you're in a healing crisis and your mitochondria are like the age of like a 70-year-old, you can probably get them back to your age, which is 50. All right. And so mitochondria are huge. In order to heal anything, in order to balance hormones, in order to heal the gut, the liver, you know, like the adrenals, like you have to have proper mitochondrial function and ATP production for that to happen. So that's number two. Number three is the gut. Right. And the gut, the reason why the gut is so important is because the gut is like the root system. If you think of a tree, for instance, right. And a tree, like a tree has healthy roots, which means they're strong and they're robust and they go deep into the ground and they absorb water and they absorb minerals. And now you have this healthy, big tree that's going to thrive for tens, if not hundreds of years. Right. If you look at a tree that has a dying root system, the whole tree is going to die. If the roots are rotting and they're failing to thrive, your tree is going to rot and fail to thrive and die. And this is the exact same with our gut, right? So our gut is the root system to our body. It absorbs all the nutrients that we need to turn it into ATP, to turn it into cells, to turn it into red blood cells, right? And when you're in a healing crisis, there's so much that is damaged in your body that you need to absorb every iota of nutrition from your food possible if you have a healthy gut system, right? And so that's why if people want healthy hormones, they have to have a healthy gut because the hormones require so much energy and like they require an enormous amount of vitamins and minerals and antioxidants to just like create the hormone or to heal the organ system that biosynthesizes the hormone. And we're gonna get to that in a second.
Hey, Health Junkies, if your feet aren't happy and healthy, the rest of you could suffer from low back pain all the way up to neck pain. And yes, even gut issues can be related to your feet because your feet are connected to your nervous system. Happy feet equal one less thing the nervous system has to worry about. I want to tell you about Paluva. This is a new zero-drop minimalist shoe with a distinctive five-toe design. Paluvas give you the most authentic barefoot style experience, but with sufficient cushioning to use in everyday movement, fitness, and athletic activities. Paluvas are super stylish, so you also get a barefoot shoe that looks good too. Paluvas are a step ahead of every other zero drop wide box shoe because they feature separate slots for each of your five toes. So if you've been using toe separators, you can ditch them and just wear the Paluvas. Those individual slots for each toe allow for correct dynamic movement of the foot through the walking or running stride, which is important when toes are encased in a single box, even a wide box. Now, minimalist shoes have faced controversy in recent years about causing injuries from inappropriate use. So you want to get walking in Paluvas, living in Paluvas, and doing whatever you can while you're going barefoot in your home and safe areas as much as possible. So go ahead and use your specialized running shoes, basketball shoes, work boots, high heels when you need to, but wear Paluvas as much as possible to reawaken the natural functionality of the human foot to stand, walk, run, and perform. Try a pair of Paluvas with no risk, and you'll quickly realize that these are the most comfortable shoes you've ever worn. They're designed to feel like you're walking barefoot on clouds. So visit Paluva, Paluva.com and take 15% off with the code HEALTHFIX. Let's get back to the podcast.
But another thing about guts that people don't understand is, you know, there's a whole program that I have around healing your gut. And so it's not just like eating healthy food, because a lot of people are like, I eat healthy food and I'm still not healing. People don't recognize like there's issues like parasites, for instance. Mm-hmm. Like a lot of people that have a health crisis actually have a parasitic crisis too. And here in the United States, I grew up in South Africa, and in other countries around the world, we just know we coexist with parasites and you have to take an anti-parasitic every year, right? That's just what it is. But doctors here in America are like, we don't have that problem. And I'm like, I didn't realize parasites have to have passports. I was clueless. You know what I mean? It's just like here in America, we have parasites. Like if you want to look at videos of parasites on food, they're everywhere across the internet. Like there's an Instagram, her name is Mrs. Rogers Hood or something on Instagram. She'll show you videos of like parasites in your food over and over and over again. Like we have parasites and we just don't care to deal with them. And so, you know, one thing about parasites is that like some of them produce substances that mimic hormone. Right. So I've had tons of women who have had like 40 to 50 day period cycles that were, you know, like they were long, they had tender breasts, they were infertile and they did a parasite cleanse. And within a month or two, they had a normal hormone system, you know? And so it's like, so yes, food is a huge part because you need all the vitamins and minerals, but you have to deal with things like parasites and fungus and, you know, toxins and stuff in the gut that are stressing your gut's ability to absorb all your food. And the reason why, again, I bring up the parasites is because a lot of people, when they have parasites, they're not absorbing the food. They're actually a walking, talking buffet for their parasites, right? So you're eating to feed parasites. So if you are that person that's like, I eat healthy and I still don't see any benefits, you might want to look into a parasite cleanse, right? Like I would say half of my clients are like that, where they're like, I just, you know, I'm doing all the things, I'm taking all the supplements and my labs still look the same. And it's like, yeah, it's probably parasites. You know what I mean? Like, and so look into parasites, like look into cleaning your gut out, like make sure you're eating the right foods necessary to absorb all the building blocks to heal your organs and to produce hormone. Because, you know, again, hormones require so much energy and they require so many vitamins and minerals. Like make sure you are eating that and absorbing it. So gut is 1, 2, 3. So gut's number 3. Did you have anything you wanted to add to that?
Oh my gosh. Well, parasites. Yes. Because, you know, yes, the connection to hormones, absolutely on point. I think the biggest thing, a lot of people are seeing it online and they're kind of like now at this point, like, oh, parasite cleansing is trendy. And I'm like, well, yes. If you're doing it 8 times a year, that's a whole nother story. But totally. And, yeah, we need to talk about that. But, you know, definitely, I do think it is a thing. My curiosity, because I think a lot of people might be thinking, like, what do you guys use in your program for parasite cleansing? What's the, like your...
My go-to is CellCore, actually. I love CellCore. A lot of people like CellCore. There are other programs that are just as good. I just love that CellCore has a foundations where it not only gets parasites, but when parasites die off, they release a bunch of fungus and lime and heavy metals. And so CellCore has like a 5-month protocol that helps you when you have the parasite die off. There are these other products that can help with the die off and the help with the toxins and all of that. So it's very supportive because when people start having parasitic die off, they have really intense symptoms and they don't have a program to support the body with that. So I like CellCore. What do you like?
Same. CellCore is my go-to. Yeah. It's my go-to. Cause I mean, a lot of people, they already don't feel good. And then they're like, you want me to do a parasite? What? And then I'm going to feel worse. Like what?
Yeah. And they do often feel worse, which is why, again, people, when they look at the CellCore foundations or comprehensive protocol, they're like, wait a second, why are there all these other things? It's like, it's a whole, it's like a football field of like different issues, right? It's never just one thing. When people have Lyme disease, it's never just a Lyme, right? It's like it's Lyme, it's heavy metals, it's fungus, it's parasites, it's, you know, there's an overburden that we have to kind of get rid of the white noise, right? And the white noise isn't just Lyme. You know, I've had tons of clients who, you know, they had Lyme and they had their whole family tested and other family members tested positive for Lyme, but are asymptomatic. And so it's like, you know, you can live with Lyme, for instance, and live a completely normal life. But why is your brother or your mom next to you symptomatic? Well, it's because their system is just overburdened and their immune system can no longer keep it at bay, you know? And so that's why I love CellCore, because it takes care of the whole system and it takes care of all those other little nuanced pieces that people would never think of, like heavy metals, you know, fungus. So gut's huge. Gut is number 3. Gut can often take months, if not years, to heal. I don't want people to, you know, when they're healing their hormones, I don't want them to feel discouraged, but I do want to create a realistic timeline. You know, it's like, you know, a lot of people are just struggling with gut issues, you know, and they're like, well, I don't have a gut issue. I'm just bloated and gassy all the time. I'm like, that's a gut issue, right? You shouldn't be bloated. You shouldn't be gassy. You shouldn't be burping. Like, you shouldn't be constipated. You shouldn't have diarrhea. You should be pooping twice a day. You know, if you're not pooping twice a day, you have a gut issue, right? Like you have to be pooping twice a day. Like, you have to be regular. And if you don't know what the Bristol scale is, look it up. You should be a four, you know, like, you should have really beautiful, soft poop. I know people are like, why are we talking about poop? It's so important. If we're not talking about poop in your consult, like, we're doing it wrong, you know? So gut is three. Now, four is really important for hormone health, and that's the liver, mm-hmm. right? Because the liver biosynthesizes all hormones. And what's really interesting, that next to the brain and the muscles, the liver actually has the highest concentration of mitochondria and ATP in the entire body. I don't know if you knew that.
I didn't.
The liver is a powerhouse, right? It's a powerhouse. So it requires a ton of ATP, almost as much as all your muscles combined in your body. You know, it requires the same ATP as the brain. So we know that the brain is working really hard, but it requires an immense amount of nutrition in order for it to heal. So it needs a lot of amino acids, which come from proteins. It needs a lot of antioxidants, which come from fruits and vegetables. It requires a lot of vitamins, which comes from fruits and vegetables. And so in order for the liver to do its job, it requires, let's go back to biological currency, right? It requires a boatload of money, right? And so that's why I say the gut comes before the liver, because the gut has to absorb all that money, give it to the liver for the liver to package hormones, right? So now we're getting to hormones finally, right? The liver also needs all that ATP to take all those vitamins and minerals and biosynthesize all the hormones in your body. All your hormones, every single one, gets biosynthesized in the liver, right? And so you have to have a functioning liver in order to have healthy, happy hormones, or in order for your body to biosynthesize them the way that it needs to into anti-inflammatory pathways, right? And so you can biosynthesize hormone in very inflammatory pathways, right? That's estrogen dominance. You know, there's different types of estrogen. You know, if you do a Dutch test, which I know you're very familiar with the Dutch test, you know, like, people that are hormone experts are experts in Dutch tests, because they recognize that the body will take a hormone and will either have it go down a pathway of inflammation or a pathway of anti-inflammation, right? And what's really important is for the liver to be on board with that. And if you give the liver the ATP, if you give the liver the vitamins, the minerals, the antioxidants, the amino acids for it to do its job, it will put it down the pathways of I want to say most resistance, but most resistance means it's anti-inflammatory, right? So again, it needs a lot of sustenance for it to take your hormone and make it a happy hormone in your body. So again, like, you have to, if you want happy hormones, you have to have a happy liver, right? You have to have a liver that is a workhorse all the time. You have a sluggish liver, you're not going to have happy hormones. You're not going to have a happy body. You're not going to have happy skin, nothing. Anything you want to add to that as far as liver health goes?
Oh man, I think we're good. We're good for now. There's a lot in terms of pathways and stuff, but I think you've covered it on a level that we got it.
Perfect. Then the next in the order of healing is number five, and it's adrenal health. And as you as your listeners probably know, and as you're an expert in, like, if you don't have happy, healthy adrenals, then you don't have happy, healthy sex hormones, right? Because the adrenals are like the organs, or the glands, sorry, that create not only cortisol, but DHEA. And DHEA is like the precursor to all the sex hormones. And so what happens is there's balance of cortisol and DHEA. And if your body, remember the control center, if it's in fight or flight, your adrenals are going to create, your adrenals are going to create more cortisol than they are DHEA. And it's going to prioritize fight or flight, right? It's going to prioritize running from that bear, right? And cortisol is very, even though cortisol itself is anti-inflammatory, its side effects are extremely inflammatory in the body. And so you want to get into a parasympathetic state to allow your adrenals to prioritize DHEA production, so that DHEA can then be turned into all the sex hormones, right? And so if you're in that fight or flight response, there's something called the cortisol steal, where your body is going to prioritize cortisol production over sex hormone production. And so it's going to actually take that DHEA that was going to be used for sex hormones, you know, and again, remember, sex hormones make you feel young and alive and vivacious and, you know, libido and good hair and good skin and good nails and reproduction, right? It's going to steal all that hormone and turn it into cortisol, right? And again, cortisol is fatigue and tired and brain fog and low energy and inflammation in the body. And you're tired all the time, but you're wired and you can't function, right? So you are now, your brain is telling your adrenals to prioritize more cortisol, more cortisol, more cortisol. And so now you are in this fight or flight response and you're creating more flight or fight response while your body is not prioritizing DHEA for sex hormone production. And I always say, like, this is why you can't, again, because hormones, sex hormones are, you can live without them, right? You can have a cake without sprinkles. And so think of your body as in, like, you can live without sex hormones. You're not going to be comfortable and you're not going to feel as pretty inside or outside, but you will live. Right. And so that's the body when we're in fight or flight, it's prioritizing survival over procreation. Right. Mm-hmm. But we want those procreating hormones because they make us feel good and they make us feel alive and they allow us to have babies. Right. But we don't have to have that. And so mm-hmm. this is what we're doing to ourselves when we're in that fight or flight response and we're signaling the adrenals to produce more cortisol, to steal all that DHEA so that we're not making sex hormones. We're making more cortisol inflammation or cortisol hormone. And so now we're stuck, right? So again, adrenal health is making sure, one, our control center, the brain, is signaling to the adrenals to produce cortisol and DHEA, and then just nurturing the adrenals to make sure it's making enough of that. So, you know, after, you know, taking care of mindset, taking care of mitochondria, taking care of the gut, the liver, when you get to the adrenals, really all you need to do is feed them. If you looked at everything upstream, you just need to feed your adrenals, and your adrenals need sodium, potassium, and vitamin C. It's so easy, right? And so if you're taking, it's so easy. If you took care of everything upstream, your adrenals are pretty much fine. You know, like your adrenals are like, we can handle this, right? But if you go straight to the adrenals and not look upstream, again, you're going to do that 5 steps forward, 8 steps back, 2 steps forward, 4 steps back. And you're going to be like, why are my adrenals so messed up? Well, look upstream. That's why they're so messed up. You're not feeding them. You're telling them to overwork. Like they're not going to be happy. So then that takes us to hormones, which is like dead last, right? And it's like, so now what do we do? Well, the beautiful thing is you don't have to do much. If you've taken care of everything, hormones can kind of just help themselves. And to be honest, like this is where you come in, because if everyone is doing everything upstream and they still have hormonal imbalance, then it's like, okay, now let's look into hormonal protocols. Now let's look into supplements. Now let's look into ashwagandha. Now let's look into organ complexes that have sex hormones in them and support. But 9 out of 10 people, if you do everything prior, like sex hormones just work. And they work beautifully and they turn on and you didn't have to even think about it, right? Because you took care of everything upstream and now your body's in this state of flow and healing. And it's like, great, we can now prioritize sex hormones and procreation because the body's actually primed for it, right? Like we're taking care of the stress with the mindset. We're taking care of the biosynthesis from the mitochondria. We're taking care of the nutritional need for the hormones by absorbing all of it in the gut. We're taking care of the hormones by having proper liver function. We're taking care of the hormones by having the adrenals produce enough DHEA for them, you know? And so then fertility is easy. Then hormones are easy, right? And very few people need to tweak protocols and take supplements for hormones because they've done all the pre-gaming, for lack of a better word. So anything that you want to add to that and what you see in your practice?
I see it all the time, because being focused in the hormonal space, you know, that's like what folks think is going to be step one. And yeah. When I'm like, so we got to go back, you know, a lot of folks are like, nah, I don't want to do that. And, yeah. You know, I believe in, you know, yes, meeting folks where they're at. And usually what happens is they'll be like, all right, let's try some hormones, see what happens. Mm-hmm. And when they don't work, right, when it doesn't work, then I'm like, okay, you ready to go back now? You know, mm-hmm. and that's fine. But I think it's also one of these things that I sometimes cringe with social media, and you probably see this too, is people will be like, I tried bioidentical hormones and everything mm-hmm. went away. And you're like,
no,
what kind of people are you seeing? Because,
right. Yes. Yes. And you know what's interesting too is it, you know, we started doing bioidentical last year. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you have to go, if you're smart, you take them through a process to be like, actually, you're not ready for bioidentical. Because it's like that inflammatory pathway again. If your body doesn't have the nutrition and the ATP production and the liver function to take a hormone and put it through anti-inflammatory pathways, if you take a bioidentical hormone, you put it in the body and the body's like, great, we're still doing inflammatory pathways. So I'm going to take this hormone and I'm going to put it through inflammatory pathways, and then people feel worse. Right. Mm-hmm. And that actually happened to a few clients where they're like, no, I want to do bioidentical. I want testosterone. I want the things. And we're like, I don't know if you're ready. And they're like, I'm ready. And it's like, okay, we'll try and see. And then they get a pellet in or something. And then they're like, oh, I had a headache for 6 months. And we're like, yeah, yes. You know what I mean? Like, so you're absolutely right. Like, you can't just quick fix it with a bioidentical hormone. It's like having the right playing field. It's almost like, I think of it like a garden, right? Mm-hmm. Have you ever gardened before?
Yes. Yes.
So it's a lot of work to just put the seed in. You have to take out the rocks and you have to take out the clay and you have to take out all the bad soil. And then you have to till it and then you have to take out more stuff and then you have to put organic soil in it and then you have to put more stuff in it. And you have like, it's so much work to just get a seed in there, right? But that's like the whole body, right? And in order to, like, if you took a seed and you went to the side of the road on a highway and you planted the seed, it wouldn't grow because the soil isn't primed for that seed to grow. So it's the same thing with hormones. You have to have a primed body to have healthy hormone function, right? And so again, going to that garden analogy, you have to do all this work to have the perfect soil. So when you plant that seed in there and water it, it grows into something beautiful. That's mm-hmm. hormones. You have to have this primed like field, like all your body systems in order for hormones to thrive in your body and go down anti-inflammatory hormone pathways versus the inflammatory ones. And so yeah, it's a lot of work. And it's interesting because I've had a few people in my Gutsy Academy because we teach the order of healing and the protocols and all that and give them food things. And I've had people who have done, you know, they've done, what's the thing called where they do artificial hormone?
The synthetic ones?
Yes. To get pregnant. I'm sorry.
IVF.
Or not. IVF. Thank you.
Yeah.
Sorry, I have mom brain right now. They do IVF for years with no success because again, the soil isn't ready to take on all that hormone and that fertility. And then they join the Gutsy Academy and in a year to a year and a half, they get pregnant. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? And it's because they've gotten their whole body ready for fertility, for, you know, cellular growth and turnover. What people don't understand is like, when you get pregnant, it's a cellular marathon. Did you train your body for that cellular marathon? Because if you haven't, if your body is primed for fight and flight and like DK inflammation, your body's not ready to take on that cellular marathon. And so what people don't realize is you have to prime your body for that cellular marathon so that you can grow that person. And that has everything to do with hormones, right? And getting the soil ready for cellular turnover, which is immense when you're pregnant. So anything you want to add to that?
Well, you know, I think it's interesting with fertility. It's one of those things we don't think about. I worked for a fertility clinic for many years when I first started, not many years, but a long time when I first started getting into acupuncture and being a naturopath. And like our protocols were foundational, were very basic, right? Mm-hmm. It was more about the IVF and doing the acupuncture to stim the body. And, you know, I would see people, they'd failed like god awful, like 5-8 IVF rounds. And you're like, this is so heartbreaking. And our protocols, I was like, you know, we could do so much more. And so when these folks would take the time to listen to me and be like, look, just stop the IVF for right now. Let's go back to foundational. I also saw a lot of change. But one of the things that I don't know if you notice, even in the older folks, like 40 plus folks like me, that sometimes when we go through the foundational protocols, we come out on the other side making our own hormones and we don't even need the bioidenticals. Mm-hmm. Have you seen that happen for you guys too? Because I want to get this out that hopefully I'm not the only one seeing this.
It can. And like what, so Dr. Wright, if you want to get him on the podcast, he'd love to talk to your audience, but you know, I think that you can support with bioidentical, but you only need very little.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean? Like a titch, you know what I mean? Like just a slight sprinkle, like not even sprinkle. You need like a salt sprinkle. You know what I mean? It's not these like heroic doses of like tons of testosterone and tons of progesterone and like 200 milligrams of progesterone. I'm like, what are they doing here? You know what I mean? It's just a slight nudge, you know? And so 80%, 90% is what you should be doing naturally, like you say. And then that tiny little 5 to 10%, that little touch, that little like sniff of bioidentical can just help your body stay there and optimize in that area. And so, you know, like I do believe that suffering is optional. And you know, as we yes. age, our bodies are designed to stop making certain hormones. And so we can just give a sniff of that hormone back in the body to just help us age more gracefully. But you know, you can actually age gracefully without it. It's just, it's better with it. That's my honest opinion. Does that make sense?
Oh, I absolutely agree. I absolutely agree. I find that some folks, because you've probably seen this, like the younger folks, like 40s, let's say early 40s who are in perimenopause are now asking for bioidenticals. And mm-hmm. I find that if we dial things in, they don't need them. But yes. once we start getting towards, you know, periods done, we have a couple years, periods done. Yes. I'm a huge fan of microdosing hormones.
Totally.
And I get a lot of crap from mm-hmm. the pharmacies because I'll write like cut patch in half, right? Like half dose. And they'll be like, that's Amazing. Not how you do it. I'm like, yeah, I know. That's how I do it.
That's how you do it. And it right. works. And like, they're not going up and down and getting all these weird side effects, right? Because it's hormone. Like mm-hmm. hormone is extremely powerful, right? It can make or break you, right? And so you want to do it. Like, I think the word I'm looking for is respectfully. Yeah. Like you want to do it respectfully. And a lot of people don't. They're like, we're just going to pound this hormone in you, like side effects be damned, right? Yeah. And so we have all these people coming into our clinic. They're like, I'm having hot flashes all the time. I'm really uncomfortable. I can't sleep. I'm anxious. And they're doing these pellets, these hero doses of pellets. Mm-hmm. And I'm just like, oh my God. Yeah. Like, unfortunately, we just have to ride this wave out and then do it more respectfully next time round, right? And like, there's different types, like there's oral versus patches. And like, there's some that work better than others, you know? And so, you know, like finding someone like you that is respectful and gentle and looks at the whole picture is huge. I think there's like a hormone clinic on every corner now that are just doing these like disrespectful, heroic doses. And it's just like, oh, please, like, please be gentle with these people's bodies, you know? So I'm right there with you where it's like, if you look at everything upstream, most of the time you don't need it. And then when you said like post-menopause, like, yeah, then let's just like do like a sniff of bioidentical to just help the body like stay in this beautiful, like youthful state.
I love the sniff. I'm going to use it. Just a little sniff. We're just going to take a little sniff off there. Exactly. It's true. Like no joke. I have patients in my practice that we take the 0.025 patch and we cut mm-hmm. it in a quarters, and that Perfect. Thing's small, and a quarter is just fine. And you know, yes, all of you who are listening, that is not what is on the label. And the pharmaceutical yeah. companies will probably say that I am prescribing that improperly. I don't care. I don't even right. care, because the little microdoses can be the difference. Right. Mm-hmm. But like we're saying here, because yes, the hormone, I could get so fired up about a hormone clinic on every corner. But anyway, the foundational stuff is what we need. And you mm-hmm. have a program, the digestion restoration course.
Yes.
That I really want to talk about, because I feel like if a lot of people could even just start there. If you're not yeah. fully bought into, like, I want to do all these steps and you guys are, I'm dabbling, not fully bought in, I think the digestion restoration course would be the place that I would think about starting. What about you? Like, give me the scoop. What do you think?
So I love the digestion restoration course, like, because it's really affordable and it gives you a lot of information. Remember, we're saying the root system to the tree is your gut. Mm-hmm. So I would start with the gut and figuring out how to absorb everything so that you can support mitochondria, you can support the liver and whatnot. If people are still intimidated to like invest in a course, there's a bunch of free courses on my website. If you go to mygutsyhealth.com, I have a microbiome 101. I have a free parasite course, you know, like start with the free classes. But like, I think the digestion restoration course, it's my most popular course. It's helped a ton of people. Like, it gives you so much information that is so like root and foundational to health and healing. It's such a great place to start. If people are like, well, what about the academy? The academy, it's an academy. It's 7 months long. We do it in a cohort. We do enrollment once a year, and it's intensive. It's like a whole lifestyle makeover. And so you have to be mentally ready for that lifestyle makeover. So I think the digestion restoration course, it's like 7 to 8 hours long, you know, of like lectures. And then there's a bunch of protocols and there's a bunch of nutritional support there for like, you know, if like menu plans for healing your gut. It's such a good course. It's my favorite course. And like I said, it's my most popular one. And I think everyone on the planet should be a gut healing expert, because 9 out of 10 people are going to someday suffer with some kind of gut issue. 9 out of 10 people suffer with gut issues, right? So it's not a question of if you get a gut issue, but when you do, yeah, right? And so optimizing on digestion is just going to help everything throughout your body. And so 100% start there. There's actually a discount code for your listeners. If they use discount code HealthFix, they can get $50 off of that course. And what's included is actually $50 off of a hair analysis, $50 off of a consult with one of my coaches to really help you dial in your healing and create a catered healing plan for you. So yes, we educate you on the gut, but then we also give you tools to help you fine tune and cater it to your healing protocols. And so it's like a whole package deal. It's a really, really great deal. So use HealthFix for $50 off of that.
Absolutely genius in terms of a package, guys. And because, like, here's what I'm going to say, because it puts the power back in you, but you can teach your family. You can have your whole family do this. Like, you buy it for you, but you got everybody else that can learn from you. Right there.
100%. We live in a day and age where like everything is geared to destroy our digestions, right? From unhealthy foods to herbicides and pesticides to antibiotic use. I mean, so many antibiotics are overprescribed. They save so many lives, but they're also overprescribed. And so we're just destroying our microbiome and our gut and our digestive functions from a very young age. And so we all need to empower ourselves with knowledge on how to reverse that damage so that we can live healthy, vibrant lives, right? And so I think everyone should become a gut healing expert. Everyone.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's a foundation of health, and it's also our way to advocate for ourselves, but also get better success in all the other things we're trying to do, whether it's our thyroids, our hormones, or whatever it may be.
Yep.
Yay. I'm so glad you have this course. I'm so glad that I have people that have taken it in my practice, because it makes me happy that we are working on that side of things, because we need the foundation. High totally. Five. You are right on the foundation. Jannine, thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you.
And I look forward to putting this one out and just sharing with folks the foundation.
Awesome. Thanks. Thank you, Dr. Jannine. Thank you so much for your time. And I'm so excited to be on your podcast. So thank you for having me.
My pleasure. Hey, Health Junkies, thank you so much for listening to another episode of the Health Fix Podcast. To help support my mission to bring you tips, tricks, and tools to help you optimize your health, I'd be grateful if you'd like, subscribe, and write me a review for the podcast. And if you hear a product you're interested in on the podcast, you can now go over to my website to learn more. That's Dr. spelled out, JKRAUSEND.com. Just click on shop and you'll find all the information on my favorite products that I stand behind and use myself. All affiliate income earned with your purchases goes directly to help support the production of the podcast so I can keep bringing you quality health information. I appreciate your support and I'm honored to have you listening to my podcast as a fellow health junkie. Thanks again. Hey, fellow health junkie, thanks for listening to the Health Fix Podcast. If you enjoyed tuning in, please help support me to get the word out about the podcast. Subscribe, rate, and review, and just get that word out. Thanks again for listening.